Hello, welcome to our latest edition of Bobcat Update. I'm Christina Willis. Today we have stories across Central Texas to bring you, but our focus, of course, is what's happening at Texas State University. Prospective students are again allowed to tour the campus. The Welcome Center at the LBJ Student Center reopened last week and is offering tours after a long break. Shelby Copeland has the story.
For many students, touring college campuses is an essential part of choosing where to go to school. For nearly 7 months, though, tours were not offered at Texas State because of the coronavirus. That's changed now. Tour guide Jessica Lucas says the university has procedures in place to keep everyone safe.
And we have to do these things to keep them safe. So we put a lot of work into it, and hopefully they see that. And I think that they're just going to be excited to tour our campus no matter what. I think they understand where we're coming from and they appreciate it.
The tours are limited to no more than 4 guests and 2 guides, and visitors must make a Zoom call to hear the guides from a distance.
We definitely want them to have a great experience here and enjoy themselves and enjoy campus, but safety, I think, is our number one.
The equipment is sanitized between tours, and staff members have their temperatures checked after each shift. The Welcome Center is pleased to be open again to show families the beautiful Texas State campus. For Bobcat Update, I'm Shelby Copeland.
Texas State's LBJ Student Center has turned its ballrooms into computer labs to accommodate students taking online courses this semester. Many students are concerned about how safe the new labs are. Bobcat Update's Jillian Polanco tells us more.
The workstations are equipped with computers or for students to bring their own devices. Some students are worried that the workspaces are not sanitary.
So I feel like a lot of students' worries about the computer lab was that it was like close together, unsafe, unsanitary in regards to like how often are people coming in and literally wiping down these stations.
Student Center employees say they are taking precautions to ensure that everyone is as safe as possible in the new computer labs.
It ranges from self-sanitizing stations to contactless check-in to sealed keyboards, all the way to fogging the entire ballrooms each morning and at night. So we're working very hard to make sure that we are thoroughly keeping our students safe.
The labs in LBJ are designed to offer a remote learning hub for students who are on campus and need a place to attend online classes. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jaylene Polanco.
Students are going back to school in many different ways this fall. Some are attending in person, some are online, and others are homeschooling. Parents have had to scramble to figure out how their children are going to be educated. Bobcat Update's Chloe McKenna has the story.
Many schools have delayed the start of the new school year to better prepare themselves for a changed environment caused by COVID-19. Students and parents ultimately get the final say on whether they want their children to remain online or go back to school in person.
To me, I felt more comfortable and she felt more comfortable of doing virtual learning. And based on how she did at the end of the year, I felt very comfortable. She had no problem dealing with virtual learning.
However, some parents work full-time, and that leaves them with fewer options on how to educate their children.
So for me, it was very important the kids go back to school because having 3 kids and working full-time, it was really hard and challenging, you know, to have a sitter. So it was really important for me to have a solution for them to be able to go into school or hire a nanny or something. But even then, really, my daughter, who doesn't like school in general, was telling me that she needed to go back.
Those who can work remotely have the option to homeschool their children. For them, having the choice alleviates some of their worries. They prefer not to send their children back to in-person classes.
For the time being, we decided to keep it virtual. Slowly but surely, we sort of developed a routine, and a lot of it revolved around the 2-year-old's nap schedule and us being able to work during that time. We're lucky enough to both have jobs that we can do from the home.
The coronavirus has forced educators and parents alike to improvise new methods for educating children. For Bobcat Update, I'm Chloe McKenna.
The San Marcos Police Department has implemented new measures to keep the public and its officers safe. Chris Huckabee went down to the headquarters to prepare this report.
San Marcos PD, like everyone, is learning how to adapt to life during a pandemic. The department has introduced new ways for officers to do their jobs effectively while practicing safety measures.
Restricted visitors into the police station itself. ride-outs, ride-alongs, those sort of things we're not doing currently.
The frequent changing of policies and safety guidelines can be frustrating for some officers. Implementing new policies is time-consuming, and everyone has to be up to date on current safety protocols.
And we have to follow whatever guidelines are out there. And so sometimes that can be a little frustrating just because some of the guidelines haven't been very clear.
Support for the department remains strong during these unusual times.
The fact that these officers are putting their life on the line already every day, and with the added stress of a global pandemic going on, it's a true testimony of their dedication as being officers.
Everyone is coping with the pandemic in their own way, and thanks to San Marcos PD, they can feel confident that the officers are promoting safety first. For Bobcat Update, I'm Chris Huckabee.
During the pandemic, many organizations have been forced to change the way they conduct themselves, and it's no different for churches. Some were not able to hold in-person services for several weeks. However, as Bobcat Update's Mark Anthony Guillory tells us, a non-denominational church in San Marcos has adapted well enough to reopen.
Like many other churches, when COVID struck, the Springs Church decided to hold its Sunday services online. The church had virtual worship for 5 months, but after some major changes, in-person services have resumed.
So I know our church, for example, is doing a lot of safety precautions. We all have to wear masks. Everyone's staying 6 feet apart. For our college ministry, we are inside, but we're all sitting apart. We're cleaning after everyone's in the room, disinfecting everything. And then for our regular church service, we're even outside so that people are socially distanced and they're outside, which is a lot safer. So yeah, we're taking every safety precaution we can so that people can still engage in community and stay safe.
Though the Springs Church has only been meeting face-to-face again for a month, its mission of helping the San Marcos community never changed. Members of the church came up with a plan to assist those who experienced life-changing events during the pandemic.
One of the ways our church is helping the community is early on back in March, we started this campaign. We called it the COVID-19 Benevolence Fund. And what we did is we invited our community to raise money to help meet the tangible needs of our community. And so since March, we've raised over $4,000, and we've been able to move that money to help feed families, to help pay bills, and to help meet, you know, needs that people have in our community that have been affected by this crisis.
The Springs Church COVID Benevolence Fund is still active. To participate in helping the church raise money for the San Marcos community, you can visit thespringstx.org. The church holds its services every Sunday at 10 a.m. If you attend, be sure to wear a mask and social distance from others not in your household. For Bobcat Update, I'm Mark Anthony Guillory.
We reported last week that the riverfront parks in San Marcos are open again, with the exception of the university-owned Sewell Park. Brady Powers tells us where we can go to enjoy the river again.
After nearly a two-month closure, the parks are again welcoming visitors who want to exercise, sunbathe, or just enjoy the scenery. Many residents are excited about the reopening.
I am very excited. I was looking forward for this date. I can't wait for the parks to be open again and being able to enjoy the outdoors with all my friends and, you know, family members.
The city is advising guests to be cautious and responsible when at the parks, making sure to practice safe social distancing, wearing a face covering when possible, and washing their hands.
I'll definitely be going to the parks now that they're all open, but I'm going to make sure to wear a mask and definitely social distance from other citizens of San Marcos to keep all the cases down.
City officials say COVID-19 case levels will be monitored to determine whether removing the restrictions is having a negative impact on public health. The city parks will be open from 8 in the morning until 8 in the evening. For Bobcat Update, I'm Brady Powers.
Now let's turn our attention to sports. The Bobcats football team traveled to Monroe, Louisiana this past weekend and earned its first victory of the season, defeating ULM 38-17. The Bobcats are now 1-2 for the season. The pandemic has affected all sports at Texas State in various ways, but the women's volleyball team is ready to put the obstacles aside and be successful this year. The team has put in the hard work to make the most of it. Players say they're excited to be on the court again and determined to outdo any opponent they face. It's a new era for the women's volleyball team. The team is now led by Coach Sean Hewitt. And just as the athletes are gearing up for game days, so is the broadcast crew working for ESPN+. The crew consists of several Texas State students who must follow new protocols to promote safety in the response to COVID-19. Bobcat Update's Sydney Tyndall has the story.
Texas State's ESPN Plus broadcast crew has returned to producing sports this fall after months of uncertainty about whether games would even be possible. Wearing masks, cutting down on crew positions, and extra care and cleaning equipment are just some of the new protocols that are now required. Broadcast Productions Manager Lucas Haskins says safety is a top priority. He says the crews are organized in a way that should reduce the possibility of cross-contamination.
If somebody ends up testing positive, they're not coming to work. And so if they come to work and spread it to other people and all of a sudden half our crew is tested positive, now we're really in a tough situation to get a broadcast on air.
Over the months, concerns about COVID-19 left some student workers unsure of how broadcast would function this fall. But now they feel assurance that it's a safe work environment.
They're doing a lot of the work for us, such as, setting up our cameras and making sure that they're clean and everything. So I actually appreciate all the work that they're doing for us and making sure that we're comfortable.
While sports may look very different this fall due to COVID-19, the excitement and community that sports brings is still present. For Bobcat Update, I'm Sydney Tyndall.
That wraps up our newscast today. We'll return soon with another recap of what's happening at Texas State and the San Marcos area. Until then, stay well. I'm Christina Willis. Bye.